Hello guys, and welcome back to Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video, we are going to talk about the most important formula from classical genetics, from which we can, you know, make direct conclusions. हमें आसानी से conclusion का पहले ही पता लग जाएगा कि कैसे क्या होने वाला है. What is the number of genotypes जो हमें मिलने वाले हैं? What is the number of phenotypes जो हमें मिलने वाले हैं? What are the total number of gametes that we are going to get? And what is the total number of progeny that we are going to get? And these conclusions will directly help us to solve a particular cross, because if our cross is having 16 progeny but according to the formula we are having only 8 progeny, it means that we are doing something wrong in cross, and that particular cross checking can be easily done with the help of small tricks or small formulas which I am going to tell you today. Before that, I would like to tell you that I am active on Unacademy, so you can follow me on Unacademy by clicking on the link given in the description below, and you can watch all the lectures made by me on the platform of Unacademy, which are on molecular basis of inheritance and human reproductive biology. Or aap log download kar sakte hain Unacademy's education app from Google Play Store for better learning experience. So let's start. The very first thing is the number of gametes, right? What is the number of gametes that are going to form when we used to cross it? The simple formula is 2 raised to power n. We have already talked about a trick, a separate video, that how we can make the number of gametes. So वहाँ पर हमने बात कर ली थी इस formula की, right? That is 2 raised to the power n, where n is the number of heterozygotes. For example, TT cross TT. This is the monohybrid cross, right? In this monohybrid cross, capital T, small t, it is heterozygote. It means that there is one heterozygote in this case, and if there is one heterozygote, there will be 2 raised to the power n number of gametes. That is, capital T will be the gamete, small t will be the gamete. That is one heterozygote and 2 gametes, right? So 2 raised to the power n is equal to 2. Quite simple. After that, 2 raised to the power n, where n can be 2 also, right? And in that particular case, such as in dihybrid cross, we have made 4 different kind of gametes in Punnett square. If this is the Punnett square, 4 gametes are there, 4 are there, and total 16 progenies are made by crossing, right? 4, 4, like this. Total 16 progenies are formed, because 4 gametes are here, 4 are here. So when the number of heterozygote is 2, it is 2 raised to the power n, that is 2 raised to power 2, that is total 4 gametes, right? And it is by each parent, okay? If this is capital T, capital T, then there is no heterozygote. It means that 2 raised to power 0, because there is 0 number of heterozygote, so total number of gamete will be 1, that is capital T, because anything raised to the power 0 is 1, okay? So वहाँ पर क्या होगा? Number of progenies will also change. After that, we will talk about the number of offspring or the number of progeny which are formed. It is g raised to the power n. It means that 2 raised to the power n is equal to number of gametes, and put that number of gametes in the place of g, and its raised to the power n will be the number of offspring. For example, in this case, 2 gametes are formed. And in monohybrid cross, 2 raised to the power 2, that is 4 progenies are formed. Okay? Jin mein se 3 were tall and 1 is dwarf. We know about it very well. So, gamete raised to the power n. In this particular case, 4 number of gametes, 16 progenies. Quite easy it is, right? So, 2 raised to the power n is the number of gametes, and number of gametes raised to the power n is the number of offspring or number of progeny. After that, what is the number of different genotype that we will get? It is 3 raised to the power n. And what is the number of phenotype that we will get? 2 raised to the power n. Right? So the number of gametes and the number of phenotype is quite same. How? Let's talk about monohybrid cross. Okay, in monohybrid cross, the ratio was, phenotypic ratio was 3 raised to 1, right? So there are 2 type of phenotypes, tall and small. Okay, do hi phenotype hai hamare paas, and 2 raised to the power 1 in monohybrid cross, 2 is the number of gametes also from one parent. In case of dihybrid cross, there is 9:3:3:1, that is 4 different kind of progenies according to phenotype, and there are 4 gametes as well. So 2^n is a correct formula for phenotype as well as a correct formula for the number of gametes. In number of genotype, which are always more, it is 3^n. Okay, and there is a fact that the number of different phenotypes and genotypes can be equal, but in most of the cases the number of genotypes is more, kyunki more than one genotype can give one phenotype. That's why the number of genotype always exceeds, right? So yahan par 3^n aa gaya, to yahan par kya hoga? For example, in monohybrid cross where only one heterozygote is present, at the place of n it is heterozygote everywhere, right? So 3^1 is equal to 3. And what is the monohybrid cross ratio? 1:2:1 for genotype. It means that 3 is correct. For dihybrid cross, 3^2, that is 9. And what is the ratio? 1:2:1:2:4:2:1:2:1. This is the genotypic ratio of dihybrid cross, which is having 9 type of genotypes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 3^2, that is 9. It is absolutely correct. So what is the number of gametes? 2^n. What is the number of offspring? g^n. Then number of phenotypes, 2^n. Again, number of genotypes, 3^n. In case of multiple allelism, what is going to be the genotypes? Very simple formula, n divided by 2, that is n by 2 into n plus 1. Okay, n by 2 into n plus 1. How we can prove that? In case of multiple allelism, we have talked about the blood groups, that they are having 3 different kind of alleles. Okay, and n is the number of alleles over here. So 3 by 2 into 3 plus 1. So 3 plus 1 is equal to 4, 4 into 3 is equal to 12 by 2 is equal to 6. 6 different genotypes. Now let's cross check. What are the 6 different genotypes? There is IAIA, that is A blood group. That is IAIO, A blood group again. IBIB, that is B blood group. IBIO, that is B blood group again. IAIB, that is AB blood group. II is O blood group. AAB, and O, which are having different genotypes, because the two AA are not having same genotype. One is IAIA and the second one is IAIO. It is different, right? So there are 6 different kind of genotypes, and the product, or we can say the final outcome that we are getting from this formula, is also 6. So all the formulas are totally verified, right? So I hope that these formulas are going to help you a lot in your examination. If you really like this video, then hit like button. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, then share this video with your friends and tell them to subscribe my channel too. Thank you so much.